Do you know what is the difference between a statement and a rule set in CSS? Do you know exactly what declaration and declaration block are? Stick to the end of this video and find out everything that you need to know about CSS terminology. This will help you talk more confidently about CSS to your coworkers, to your bosses, and especially on your next job interview. Let's dig into CSS terminology. All right, first and foremost, as you probably already know, CSS stands for cascading style sheets. By definition, CSS is not a programming language, it's not a markup language like HTML is, but instead CSS is stylesheet language, and that's exactly why we have here stylesheets. And cascading refers to the rules that govern selectors or how styles are applied to the page. We will not dig into the details here, this is closely related to specificity, so let's examine some CSS code. This is something that you would typically see in CSS, and some people refer to this like a selector or a block of code, but as a matter of fact, by definition, everything that you see on a screen here is called a rule set, or oftentimes we just refer to this as a rule. A rule set, at its core, is a set of CSS properties associated with CSS selector. So let's dig into those terms. CSS selector is exactly what you see on a page here. It is a string that identifies which elements certain properties or certain styles will be applied to. Selectors can be simple and complex. Simple selector would be something like we have on the screen right here. It's an element selector, H1. This would target an H1 HTML element. Then we can have class selectors or ID selectors. And if you only have a class or ID, this would be a simple selector. And if you combine multiple types of selectors, maybe more elements or more classes, we could have here div H1 selector, which would then target H1 elements within a div. And we can also combine classes, IDs, elements all together. And those would then be called complex selectors. If we go further, we have a declaration. And declaration is exactly what you see on the screen here. It consists of two major parts. In this example, margin block is the first part and two rem units is the second part. Margin block is a logical CSS property. If you're not sure how logical properties work in detail, or if you want to learn more about logical properties, check out my guide on logical CSS properties. Link should be on the screen right now. A declaration consists of two parts, and this would be a property and a value associated with that particular property. And of course, every rule set, every rule can have multiple declarations. Like this is the first declaration that we have on the screen here, and this would be the second one, color and a value associated with that color. And those declarations together are called a declaration block. So if you have multiple declarations in a single CSS selector, then this is called a declaration block. So in this declaration block, we have two declarations, and each declaration has its own property. A property at the core is a stylistic parameter that can be influenced through CSS. In my South complicated, but property basically only tells the browser what you want to change. This would be margin block property for this declaration. And for the second declaration, property would be color. There are values associated with those properties, and those values would be two rem units for our margin block property. And for our second declaration, where we have a color property and a value associated with that color property would be HSL 0, 80%, 40%. And speaking about HSL color format, link to a guide on HSL should be on the screen right now. If you want to learn more about that, if you want to learn in detail exactly how HSL works and how you can utilize it in your own style sheets. In any case, one thing to know about values and properties as well is that both are case insensitive, so it doesn't matter how you write them, uppercase or lowercase. Usually a standard is to write in a lowercase, but CSS at the core doesn't distinguish between those. It's case insensitive. There is one more thing that I would like to show you. So if we return to one of our previous slides or to our rule set, rule sets are the main building blocks of style sheets, and a typical style sheet often consists of many, many rules, but style sheets don't only contain rule sets, they also contain other information that authors like you want to convey to the browser. Those can be external style sheets that you want to import into your existing style sheet. Those can be external fonts that you want to use within your style sheet, and so on. Those are a bit different. They always start with the @ rule, and they're not called rule sets. They are called statements, but the rule set is also a statement. So a statement in CSS can be a rule set or an @ rule, like we have right here. At import, we are importing another style sheet into our existing style sheet. This would be a statement. Then we have another statement here, which is a font face statement. Bear in mind that this is not an entire declaration. We would need to specify the source for this font family that we're defining here. So this part of code here, at font face and everything within curly braces, would be called a statement. Exactly the same as our previous part of code. So at import and at font face are statements. And this part of code here h1 and everything within curly braces is also a statement, but as we've seen a little bit earlier, it is also a rule set, and that is the key distinction between a rule set and a statement. With that, we've covered the basics of CSS terminology, but there are also other terms in CSS like inheritance, pseudo-class, pseudo-element, replaced element, specificity, and a few more. And if you want to learn more about those, please let me know in the comments. Just give a thumbs up emoji so I know if you actually want me to create another video that would cover another part of CSS terminology. Maybe we go a little bit deeper into different, more specific, more complicated topics. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in the next CSS rule set, or rather, in the next video.